Wow, Harry. Harry. Off to a good start. A warm welcome to you as we continue our journey together at Tokyo 2020. So, on your marks, get set, and let's go and see what day six delivers. How about this for a view that's out of this world? We head to space for an Olympic workout. US athlete Colleen Quigley looks back to move forwards with her Olympic hopes. And Harry Sugiyama breaks sweat to show us the Imperial Palace. Two Olympians at opposite ends of their career timeline. When skateboarding legend Tony Hawk tweeted footage of a Brazilian dubbed the Flying Fairy in 2015, no one could have predicted that same young girl would become the sport's first ever Olympic silver medalist in Tokyo almost 6 years later. Congratulations again, Hayesa. Now, looking ahead is something Olufunke Oshonaike has been doing since 1996. That's when the Nigerian table tennis player made her Olympic debut. And to save you doing the maths, that makes her appearance at Tokyo 2020 her seventh Games.
Before coming here, I was like, Funke, are you for real? Are you going for your seventh Olympic? Because 5 years ago, it was just a dream, you know. I remember Rio, when I was in the hall and the guys were getting inducted to seventh club, you know. Then I just looked at them, I said, where are the women? We don't have any women in the seventh club. And I just told myself, oh, Funke, you know what? I know you're growing old, but you can try one more time. But right here, I'm here, so it's a dream come true.
Hey, Olufunke, if you've done seven, maybe you can stick around for number eight. Now, athletes are used to hanging around ready to compete, but spare a thought for the crew aboard the International Space Station. Astronaut Thomas Pesquet ran us through their fitness routine and love of the games.
You have to be fit when you're an astronaut. It's a requirement of the job. Because you have to withstand the acceleration during launch and landing. And we focus on the core muscles, muscles that maintain your spine, the leg muscle, your back muscles, all those muscles that you use every day on the ground, but we don't up here because we just float. We can move about by just pushing with one finger on the wall. We can lift and carry really heavy loads just using a very, very tiny bit of our force. Actually, the spacewalk is like a marathon that you run with your upper body, because we move in a pressurized suit that resists your movements. And we use our upper body, our arms, to move around for 7 hours at a time, sometimes more. And so you need to be very, very fit. And obviously, judo helped a lot, working out helped a lot, rugby as well. But also, I think running, long distance running, teaches you how to pace yourself, how to go at your own speed. No need to, you know, start running too fast and then get tired, things like that.
From a view all around the world to a look at all around artistic gymnastics from this day in time. Over 11,000 Olympians are here in Japan, but for some athletes, Tokyo 2020 will be seen from their own homes. Steeplechase runner Colleen Quigley took the difficult decision to hit reset this summer, but she'll still be cheering on Team USA.
Unfortunately, this summer, my body just kind of decided that it didn't like everything new and different and kind of freaked out on me. Ended up having some nerve issues right before the Olympic trials for track and field, and had to pull out at the last second, which obviously was not how I wanted the summer to end, but I also am just feeling super confident that I made the right decisions for me and for the long-term success of and health and happiness of my career. And, you know, with the disappointment of not being in Tokyo right now, I know that, you know, I have set myself up for success over the next 4 or 8 years, however much, you know, however longer I get the honor of running and competing for Team USA. Hope to be back in Paris in 2024, but this summer I'm definitely rooting on Team USA track and field, but also I love watching the other sports too.
And what about your event? How do you feel
Am
thinking
I gonna watch?
About watching the 3,000 meters steeplechase? Yeah,
I will watch for sure. Emma Coburn and Courtney Frericks are two good friends of mine. You know, we've made every team together since I graduated college. So I know they're going to represent Team USA really, really well. They actually went 1-2 in 2017 at World Championships in London. Emma won gold and Courtney won silver. So I know they're going to pack a couple punches out there, and I'm definitely going to watch and wait for some amazing races and maybe even American record to go down if the race is really fast. I know that both of them have been training their butts off all summer, and they're both in really good shape, and they're both, you know, healthy and just have been training really hard. So I know they're going to represent us well, and looking for one, if not two, medals and maybe a record to go down in the steeple. So I'll definitely be watching.
Are you calling a record?
It could happen. It definitely could happen. I know Emma just tried to go for it last week. So that'll be exciting. I also have friends from other countries. Genevieve Akaz is from Australia. And then Gesa Kraus is a German friend of mine who'll be in the steeple. So besides Team USA, I have lots of fun women to root for who, you know, I think in track and field, and it's probably true in many sports, we are fierce competitors, but I respect the heck out of all those women. I know they've worked their butts off to get there. So I do wish them, you know, all the best. And I hope that everyone can be healthy and just have a really good, clean race. And I know those moments are so well earned. You know, there's so many hours that are spent preparing for it. So I wish them all nothing but the best for sure.
Thank you, Colleen. And we're happy you and your health are the priority. So how about Haru Sugiyama puts in the hard yards in your absence? As we're about to discover, Tokyo is a jogger's dream.
Right in the middle of a massive metropolis I call Tokyo, there's this heaven of green and heaven of history. We are on the outskirts of Imperial Palace. It's actually a 5 kilometer jog, run, walk, whatever you want, right around this historical place, and the scenery is beautiful. The Otemon Gate, East Gardens of the Imperial Palace, the beautiful Ishigaki stone walls. Two kilometers. Boiling in Tokyo right now, 35 degrees Celsius. So when your body starts to heat up, oh, just come over here and chill out. 3 kilometers. The end is close. Okay, I'm done. Running at the Imperial Palace, definitely an experience.
Oof, Harry, that was 5 kilometers in record pace. Although you're not quite as fast as an origami artist. And don't forget, Olympics.com is home to all the latest news, results, schedules, and analysis, as well as our live blog. And how about we do this again on day 7? See you then.